I think what I discovered making this series was that nobody really knew what happened. And after making the series, we've discovered we still don't know what happened with them. Nobody
that will
knew.
Come in the next season.
Yeah, that's the next season.
Season two.
Yeah. So
that one is really controversial.
So yeah, somewhere you discovered that no matter whatever happened, there was a respect intact. And yeah, that was like no one spoke beyond something. And I think that was something heartening.
You know, I think all of us who grew up in the 80s and were children of the product of films that were made in the 70s, we all carry the legacy of Salim Javed within us. It's not about just being a part of their family. It really is, as audiences, as viewers, the impact and influence of their film on all creative minds was just, it's undeniable. You know, so it has influenced my work. When I write scenes, I mean, it's not about emulating or copying consciously, but there is a certain darja, for the lack of another word, you know, that was given to the parts that they had written. And every character contributed in some way, had a personality, had a way of speaking, had a moment in the film. And I think that is subconsciously kind of come into the kind of writing that we do. A piece of advice that my dad gave me, he said, we come from a long tradition where sons never listen to their fathers. So please don't listen to me. Go ahead, go ahead and do whatever you want. So I tried my best to follow his advice.
We have no choice because this angry young man, I think my father is the angrier one. So we still listen to whatever he says. I think Zoya started this. Yeah. And Zoya and Farhan came to me. To all of us, and I thought that was the best thing that could ever happen.
Fantastic.
And I believe that they were the highest paid writers then. They're not leaving that position only. Even now. Look at this. Or ye to achha hai, they didn't pursue acting. They didn't write for themselves. Ne to look at them.
So handsome.
Aajkal bhi aise do hero nahi milenge aapko.
I mean, I think you're right. I had no exposure to films till I obviously, we did Dil Chahta Hai. But I think a lot of it came because from school, I remember Javed Uncle used to be at Holiday Inn working there. So I used to go there because our school was right across. And I used to hop across there with Farhan. And I would see some part of the process of what was the magic behind, right? So I think I got into it at that point. And then obviously you've grown up watching these movies in the 80s. And I think even today, like, and with Salim Uncle, most of my interaction started after Dil Chahta Hai, because I remember after the movie release, Farhan and me, for most of the films, would go invite him. I obviously knew the family, Sohail, Arbaaz, Salman, all these people from C-Rock days. So, I mean, there was a lot which was there. So, I mean, I think there is a lot of influence in the work today, because you've seen the stories they wrote, the way that the nuances of the screenplay, the characters, the emotional connect they had at that point, and it's even valid today. So, I mean, to be honest, even when I read a screenplay today, I try to find that connect and that emotion with which you can relate to and identify with.
And we in our industry are used to, we have to work under a lot of pressure. And he was already used to it.
he let him say it.
You only say.
Abhi bol do abhi.
Because Marlik's pressure cooker belonged to him. So he'd already come from that background of working under pressure.
You know, it's wonderful for us to partner with Prime, Amazon Prime, and you know, it's going to drop in 240 countries. And to me personally, I mean, apart from it being a them being a huge contribution to the film industry, when I watch the docu-series, it's like two tigers who've done this beyond all odds. So there's a rags to riches story, there's a beyond all odds kind of story, and I think it's very universal, their journey.
Well, I mean, I've been an editor for 15 years now. And when Zoya asked me if I would love to do this, I mean, if I would want to do this, I was like, yes, because it just seemed like a great subject. And I mean, it was much more than what I thought. It was so amazing. It's been quite transformative for me. Yeah, it's been a great learning experience. And it feels surreal that it's happening, that everybody will get to see it. We have poured our hearts into it. We've worked on it for a long time. And I hope everybody can see it and enjoy it.
Achha lag raha hai. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सलीम साहब.
नहीं ऐसा नहीं है, आने वाले पिक्चर भी अच्छे होना चाहिए. इस पे काम नहीं चलेगा.
एक्चुअली हम लोग थोड़े इनसिक्योर हो गए थे पीछे बैठे, एक एक के बाद एक सबको बुलाया जा रहा है, हमारा कोई जिक्र नहीं है, तो हमें कहीं ये भूल भूल तो नहीं गई था, हमें रिमाइंड कराओ भाई हम भी हैं.
और मेरा ये है कि उससे बहुत से लोगों को बहुत तकलीफ होगी, इसलिए कि हमें तो थोड़ी बहुत अकल थी, बाकी बहुत बेवकूफ थे.
आई मीन अल्टीमेटली द रिजल्ट, बट यू सी इट वॉज नॉट प्लान्ड, इट वॉज नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज, इट वॉज नॉट ऑन वेरी कॉन्शियस लेवल डिसाइडेड दैट विल डू दैट, इट जस्ट हैपन. Incidentally, the first job I got in film industry was with Mr. Kamal Reddy for 50 rupees. Then I jumped to 100 rupees in Mr. S.M. Sagar's film, where I was an assistant director. Besides that, I was writing dialogue also, because no other writer was willing to write the dialogue of Saradi Lutera. तो हम लोग झोपड़ पट्टी में भी गए थे माहिम की सागर साहब के साथ, वहाँ एक राइटर था उसने भी रिफ्यूज कर दिया. फिर मुझे उन्होंने कहा अच्छा चलो तुम लिखो, तो मतलब चॉइस का मामला नहीं था, मगर वो मेरी जिंदगी की शायद सबसे अहम फिल्म है सरहद लुटेरा, बिकॉज दैट इज वेयर आई मेट सलीम साहब. सलीम साहब उस पिक्चर में रोमांटिक लीड कर रहे थे और मैं डायलॉग लिखता था, और मुझे इतना परेशान करते थे वो डायरेक्टर साहब और प्रोड्यूसर साहब कि मैंने तय कर लिया था इसके बाद मैं नहीं लिखूंगा. मगर मुझे कॉन्स्टेंटली जो हिम्मत दी और अप्रिसिएशन दिया वो सलीम साहब ने, कि आप अगर इस पिक्चर में ऐसे डायलॉग लिख सकते हैं तो आप सोचिए कोई ठीक पिक्चर होगी तो आप क्या करेंगे, आप राइटर बनिए. तो ये खैर बात खत्म हो गई. उसके बाद इत्तेफाक है कि मैं बांद्रा आ गया एक दोस्त के यहाँ, और उसके साथ रहता, किराया वो देता था मैं रहता था. तो सलीम साहब का घर पास में था, तो सलीम साहब के घर जाने लगा सारी मोहब्बत के साथ. एक ये था कि एक वक्त का खाना पक्का हो गया था, तो फिर हम लोग बैठते थे कहानियां वानियां सोचते थे. एक दिन हम बैठे थे कि वही सागर साहब जिन्होंने सरहद लुटेरा बनाई थी, जिन्होंने हमें इंट्रोड्यूस कराया, वो आ गए और उन्होंने कहा भाई एक शॉर्ट स्टोरी है और तुम दोनों जो है वो उसका अगर स्क्रीन प्ले बना दो. तो हमने कहा ठीक है, कितने पैसे देंगे आप? तो उन्होंने कहा 5,000. तो आइए, मेरा तो एक हार्ट बीट मिस हो गया. तो हमने कहा ठीक है. तो हमने 14-15 दिन में वो स्क्रीन प्ले बना के उन्हें दे दिया. ये गोस्ट राइटिंग थी, हमारा नाम नहीं था पिक्चर में. लेकिन वहाँ एक सुधीर वाही थे जो अभी भी शायद आपके टच में है. तो सुधीर वाही जो है उसको तो मालूम था कि हमारा काम है, तो उसने कहा सिप्पी फिल्म चले जाओ. तो हमने सोचा सिप्पी फिल्म इतनी बड़ी हो हमें कहाँ काम देगी. लेकिन एक दिन दोपहर में कुछ करने को नहीं था तो मैं चले ही गया. तो वहाँ बात बात की तो उन्होंने कहा अच्छा आप दोनों आ जाइए. मैंने कहा हम लोग तो साथ काम कर रहे थे, अभी खत्म किया हमने स्क्रिप्ट, तो आप दोनों आ जाइए. तो फिर हम दोनों गए और फिर हमें वहाँ काम मिल गया. तो वहाँ राजेश खन्ना से मुलाकात हो गई. राजेश खन्ना ने हमें कहा कि तुम हाथी मेरे साथ एक स्क्रीन प्ले लिख दो. तो कोई ऐसा दिन नहीं था, कोई ऐसा टाइम नहीं था जब हम दोनों ने बैठ के तय किया कि अब हमें पार्टनर हो जाना चाहिए. इट जस्ट ग्रू, इट हैपन लाइक दैट. और फिर तो आपको पता ही है, मुझे बताने की जरूरत नहीं है, रेस्ट इज हिस्ट्री.
हम जा रहे थे करता हुआ एक फिल्म के उस पे प्रीमियर पे, हम जावेद चाम्बर में एक ही गाड़ी में थे जा रहे थे, और हमारे सामने एक प्रोड्यूसर डायरेक्टर जा रहे थे जिन्होंने 20 साल पहले एक फिल्म बनाई थी. तो बच्चे आए और ठोकना शुरू कर दिया और बॉनेट को, सलीम जावेद जिंदाबाद, सलीम जावेद जिंदाबाद. तो एक 10 रुपए का नोट निकाला मैंने, फिर उनका कहा कि ये लो, और वो जाके आगे को जो उनका नाम दिया डायरेक्टर का कि उनकी गाड़ी के आगे क्या करो, और उनका नाम दिया कि जिंदाबाद बोलो, जिंदाबाद बोलो. जो वो जैसे जैसे जाके उसने जिंदाबाद बोलना शुरू किया तो उन्होंने पीछे मुड़ के देखा देखा जानते हैं और इसके बाद गाड़ी घर चली. तो इंटरवल में जब सिगरेट पीने निकले तो हम लोग ढूंढ रहे थे कि हम कहाँ हैं. जो उसके बाद हम दिख गए उसे, तो घुमा फिरा के, जैसे आपने भी अभी थोड़ी देर पहले कहा था लोग जानते हैं और हर आदमी जानता है, तो थोड़ी देर बाद वो हमारे पास आके खड़े हो गए. कहने यार अल्लाह का शुक्र है कि 20 साल हो गए मेरी पिक्चर को, मेरा बच्चा बच्चा जानता है.
You know, I mean, I think, like, you know, Zoya said it in the trailer, which you get a sense as there was nobody like them and there's nobody after them on this. And I think even just talking about what they do as writers and what they've done, we were just discussing this even backstage, that all of us sitting here, all of us, have a job because these two people went and wrote something and brought that to life. So I don't think that is what needs to be shared with the world. That's what I think needs to, this generation needs to see what kind of writers and what they do. So I think without writers, we are actually nobody. We have no job. So I think a story like this coming to the forefront and sharing it with the world is the best thing we as Salman Khan Films, XL, Tiger Baby could do and take it out there.
My earliest memories are of the spaces, I think. Certain hotel rooms, the study in our house now, which for my luck is my room right now, the study they worked in. I think it's the spaces. I think it's that A4 blank foolscap sheet and handwriting. That's my earliest memory of it.
You know, I've watched all their work umpteen number of times. So be it Shole, be it Diwar, be it many films. But the one that I think I've watched the most that they worked on was a film called Kranti, which I watched, I don't know, maybe like 300 times. I saw that film. It was highly entertaining. I don't know if they will be happy that that was my first choice of Kranti. But no, all their work. I think this documentary is aptly titled Angry Young Men because they brought their life experience, their voice, their identity into the character that we've all come to know as Vijay. And that's left like a lasting impression on all of us. But all of it, their work is absolutely spectacular. It speaks for itself.
Salman, sir,
I just saw an interview of Mr. Manoj Kumar, and he's taken away the credit from Salim Javed. He said that he's written it.
Did he?
Yeah.
Okay. So then we'll have a separate documentary for Manoj.
I think it's very, very honest of him that he has made this confession.
No, but it's a fact. It's a fact. He says, "Main likhta tha, main unko sunata tha, aur ye phir aake wahi karke chale jaate the." So but he did write it. I've liked all the films, but for me, Deewar, Zanjeer, Dawn, Shole. Ab kitne naam le? Ke jab hum like we produce a film, I'm sure even Farhan and Zoya must be revisiting all their films. Kya sawal hai ye? अब इसका इस सवाल का जवाब तो कुछ और ही होगा कि जब से कुछ समझ में आया तो सलीम जावेद ही समझ में आए, बाकी के कोई नहीं समझ में आया.
आई मस्ट इन ऑल ऑनेस्टी एक्सेप्ट दैट सलीम जावेद स्टेप ऑन मेनी पीपल फीट, बट टू बिगिन विद दोज फीट शुड नॉट हैव बीन देयर.
ज़ोयाज़ आइडिया, I mean, even when she had the idea first, she knew that it will be called Angry Young Men.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah, and we discussed it back in 2018. She already knew it's Angry Young Men.
Thank you.
It's a fab name.
Truly is.
Yeah,
Thank you. It
epitomizes everything the docuseries is about.
Giving hit after hit, hit after hit, hit after hit. And now they have to refuse a lot of producers, a lot of actors. तो वो वहां से आता है कि ये लोग अपने आप को समझते कि इनका दिमाग खराब हो गया है. दिमाग इनका नहीं खराब हो गया था, दिमाग इनका चल ही रहा था और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से चल रहा था क्योंकि ये हिट पे हिट दिए जा रहे थे और जिनके साथ ये काम नहीं कर पाए फॉर डेट्स और प्लॉट पसंद नहीं आया, फॉर व्हाटएवर, शक्ल पसंद नहीं आई, जो भी है कैरेक्टर पसंद नहीं आया, वो उन्होंने इनको टैग कर दिया कि इनका दिमाग खराब था, लेकिन एक्चुअली इनका नहीं था. जिन्होंने इनको ये बोला है वो उनका दिमाग खराब है.
आई थिंक द ऑडियंस इज ऑन दिस स्पेसिफिक वन, अपार्ट फ्रॉम ऑल द ग्रेट थिंग्स दैट वी हैव हर्ड, इज फैंटास्टिक स्टोरी टेलिंग, राइट? लाइक, एंड इट्स द स्टोरी बिहाइंड द स्टोरी, यू नो, दीज आर आइकॉनिक राइटर्स हुव क्रिएटेड आइकॉनिक कैरेक्टर्स एंड आइकॉनिक फिल्म्स, एंड आई पर्सनली सी अ लॉट ऑफ न्यू फिल्म्स टुडे and you can tell that there is, you know, a little bit of Salim Javed in every film, you know, whether it's a character, it's a story. So there is a lot that you're going to see, and then there is you know, some trivia that I can't really talk about, But yeah, it's something that we're very
talk
excited
about. Talk about it. Talk about it.
But yes, there is a lot to be seen. 3 episodes, power-packed, 240 countries, and 20th August. That's all I want to say for now.
Amazon ka promotion. You know, one thing, I've worked with a lot of writers, and so has Farhan, with a lot of writers. They write. Salim Javed thought. They put their life's experiences, what they've learned from people around, what they've seen, what their parents have taught them, what their children, you know, have, you know, the way they've grown up. So they've taken from life and they put it on cinema. The rest of the writers, cinema se utha ke, cinema mein dala hai. God makes men. They don't want to be men anymore. He makes a lot of men. But in this generation, they don't want to be men. These two here, my father and Javed Saab, they're men, they're still men, because they want to be men.
I think their grit, the fact that, you know, like Saman just said, what they were writing at that time, it was so reflective of what was happening in society. And also, I think writers were treated quite shabbily at that time. You know, in the industry, they had no status. And these two gentlemen came and just kind of broke all of that. And just shattered, you know, the glass ceiling. And it's very inspiring. And I think it's inspiring to somebody who's not a filmmaker or a writer too. Because it's your genuine rags to riches, against all odds kind of story.
Tell you that that we are going to write now. I have spoken to him ki ek picture bas hum ek aur likh de saath.
Well, line yahan se shuru hoti hai.
Us zamane mein bhi hamari price zyada thi. Is zamane mein to bahut hi zyada hogi. Wo dekh lijiyega. मगर एक बात, हमारे बच्चों ने, सब बच्चों ने बड़ी अच्छी अच्छी बातें हमारे में कही, लेकिन सच ये है कि तो बहुत छोटे थे, नहीं क्या कितना याद है कितना नहीं. हम तो बड़े थे, हमें याद है ज्यादा इन बच्चों के बारे में. मैं सलीम साहब से जब पहली बार मिला था तो सलमान वॉज नॉट इवन 1 ईयर ओल्ड, 65, ही वॉज नॉट 1 ईयर ओल्ड. और ये जो अभी इतने हैंडसम लग रहे हैं, ये कोई अभी की बात नहीं है, बचपन से ही खूबसूरत थे. So he was an exceptionally good looking child. और एक ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट तस्वीर आपके लिविंग रूम में हुआ करती थी, छोटी सी फ्रेम में, सलमान की पता नहीं अब है, एक हो गई कहाँ है. फिर ये सब तो बाकी बच्चे तो मेरे सामने पैदा हुए हैं. अच्छा, कमाल क्या है कि सलमान टूडे ही द ही मैन, ही द डैशिंग हीरो, इंतहाए शाय, बहुत ही कम बोलने वाला, बहुत चुपचाप रहने वाला बच्चा था. जो बदमाश बच्चा था वो वहां बैठा हुआ है. He was a regular seducer. सलीम साहब के घर में जो भी आता था कि ये तुम्हें पता नहीं है तुमने क्या क्या किया 6 बरस के बाद. ये जो भी इनका, सलीम साहब का दोस्त होता था, ये उससे एक स्पेशल रिलेशन बना लेते. ये बेचारा चुप बैठा रहता था. और ये जो है उससे मिलके घुल मिलके लोगों को लगता था भाई बहुत कमाल का बच्चा है, है? और एक बहुत छुटपन में इसकी एक अजीब आदत थी, इसके बाल कभी बिखरे नहीं मिल सकते थे. ये कंघी करता था. एक 6 साल का बच्चा अपनी कंघी कर रहा है, ऐसा मैंने देखा नहीं कभी. तो सेल्फ लव इनका बहुत कमाल का था.
तो ये उस वक्त से थे. Well, see, the way they've lived their lives today is very difficult for Farhan and me to live our lives the way they've lived their lives. So, isme negative bhi bahut aa gaya us waqt. So, they didn't care. Today, we are made to feel that we should care, where we should not actually.